I mean, we made a concerted effort coming into this game to try to speed our game up, so we didn't do anything slowly. I think we addressed that today. We addressed a lot of things that we felt that were important to how we're building, to the identity that we want to be. Our last four periods, I mean, even the 3-on-3, if you want to count that one, our last five periods have been right, to use the word that we use with our team. We played right today. We were blocking shots for each other. We were doing some heavy lifting for each other. We were really proud as a coaching staff. Nobody wants to lose, especially in a shootout, of course. 1,000%. It's not something we ever want to do, but we're certainly proud of the way that the team performed tonight, and we know that that's another brick in the wall of what we're trying to build here.
I mean, after today, it looks like you guys, you know, are so close to, I guess, metaphorically knocking that wall down, getting the first one of the season. And like you said, no one wants to lose in a shootout, but what was it like in the locker room? What did you say to the guys? Obviously, it's only been a few minutes after the game.
I mean, if you think about anything that we do in sports that we're lucky enough to make a living in, or not lucky enough to do college athletics in as a player, it's an emotional experience. The journey from the start of the game to the end of the game is such a roller coaster. It's up and down, and the momentum swings, which is something that we want to handle. You know, when you go down, we push right back and we come back. Like that was something we're really excited about as a coaching staff. You go down one, bang, we come back. They score another one, bang, we come back. You know, our 5-on-5 goals tonight were a huge, huge part of what we're trying to do, and very important to us. How we scored those goals was very important to us. Penalty kill, we still have to clean up. I mean, that's a top-rated power play unit, one of the best power plays I've ever seen. And, you know, we were able to shut them down for a bunch of their power plays, and we don't get it clear. That's the difference in a game. Like, it's literally one missed clear that we were working and we were trying on it, but the puck doesn't get cleared, and then we get scored on. So that's a tough one, but They're just all pieces of what we're trying to do. We got to do some landscaping, and when you do landscaping, you're going to have a messy yard sometimes. We started off in September with a really messy yard, and now we're just kind of raking the leaves over and trying to tidy things up and finding the weeds, and we're going to water the flowers too.
You were talking, like you just said, about that emotion. You really noticed, I think, that started at the end of the game yesterday, a lot of scrappiness going on, a little bit shoving. You saw a very physical game today, I thought, at least from the media standpoint. Is that something that you guys are trying to push towards, or is that something that you're just noticing coming on with the team? Where do you see that coming from?
You know, the word blue collar gets thrown around so easily, you know, and I don't know if I feel even comfortable using that word, but we want to have a working mentality here. And we feel that part of that is sticking up for each other smartly. We do everything together. We win together, we lose together. And if we do lose, we don't lose with any independent contractors. We do it playing the way that we're trying to play. And at the end of the game last night, Nick Hamry is one of the hardest, toughest players I've ever had the privilege of coaching. And he's not 6'5". But he plays like he's 6'5". And for him to get in there and take on a guy that's got at least 40 pounds on him, get in and finish a hit and take a couple punches to the head, that kind of got under their skin a little bit. That's an advantage for us. As long as we don't do anything illegal and we don't have any players get suspended, we're okay with us sticking up for each other and sticking up for the team and sticking up for the logo. There's a pride in the logo too. So we thought that going into this game, it was going to be a nasty type game. Game that we have to be comfortable playing in the trenches. That's a mantra of ours too. We want to be a team that's comfortable in those trenches. And we felt that tonight we responded. Like, we, you know, that in the warm-up, you know, there's, you know, some threatening looks and you know, all that kind of stuff. But I thought the game settled down pretty quickly. There wasn't a ton of, I didn't see anything dirty, for example. We saw some unbelievable hits, like when Tristan Mullen blew that guy up in front of our bench right there. Like, that was, you know, it's crazy. It's like a meteor coming through.
I know you haven't had a chance to obviously, you know, look at the film yet, game just ending, but what going into this next week of practice do you think is going to be the focus?
Well, this is an uncomfortable week for us because tomorrow's going to have to be a day off. We have to give the guys a day off, and then we have 2 days of practice, and then we travel, and then it's actually a 1 o'clock game, so we don't have the advantage of having another practice. So it's going to be us getting to what we need to get to the fastest. We really believe as a team that the team that does the most work between now and the end of this season, that's going to be the team that has success. So we want to be that team. We want to never cheat the process. We believe in this process as a team. To a man on this team, we believe in the structure. We believe in this process. So we have to adjust to this. We're only going to have 2.5 practices, really, before we play Providence, which is another great team. So we're facing the best teams right off the bat, but that's given us the scars that we want to have. That's building the character right now. So when we do get to the playoffs, we're a little bit battle-tested.